All right. Chloe, what you doing?
I'm cutting.
You're cutting? What are you cutting? Hey. Hey, Batu. Hey, Prosales. What are you cutting?
Eggplant.
Eggplant. Welcome, everybody. This is Joy. Hi, I'm Joy. Let me see. Hi. And this is Chloe, and we are making dinner on the Stevens Suburban Homestead. Hi, Dizzy. So, Chloe is cutting up homegrown eggplant, which looked like this. And when you have homegrown eggplant, you want to make sure to peel it. I've never let Chloe peel anything, but since I'm videotaping, hey, Hannah Banana, go ahead and peel for the very first time. Hopefully she doesn't cut yourself. You see Mama do it? Uh-uh. That's dangerous. Good Lord. Here, I'll hold it. You try to cut it. I may have to do this part. Okay. Anyway, let's just show them real quick what we're having for dinner. Hey. All right, we, of course, include on the homestead composting, so when we're done with our scraps, boom. So hopefully y'all will remember that as well. We home grew this green pepper. You can actually cut that, babe. And home grew the eggplant, and we're going to put that in with some fresh garlic and some mushrooms, and we have some ground turkey meat and onions. All organic, not all homegrown, unfortunately. Now, a tip, if you're using turkey because you're just cutting back on like cholesterol, you might need to put a little bit of olive oil in it to get a little bit of that oil in there. It's not low fat, obviously, but it's harder. It's more heart healthy. Harder, healthier? Anyhow. Okay, and we are a gluten-free household. I have celiac. And we're not 100% gluten-free, but now they make some pretty inexpensive processed food that's gluten-free, so that's something else we do. Tonight, because I haven't had homegrown tomatoes yet that I've canned, we're going to have some tomato sauce and some canned tomatoes. I try to buy organic when I can find it, and we are also a heart-healthy house because of Grandpa Ron, who had a heart attack. We do a lot of no-salt added. Now, I will tell you, since Grandpa doesn't live with us anymore, we do add some salt, like when we sweat our vegetables, but we have cut our salt down by leaps and bounds. So that's what's for dinner. If anybody's out there now looking for ideas, I hope that's inspired you. It's almost 6 o'clock, and again, I'm late today. And what we're going to do to save time and money again, that's one of the things we always talk about. Okay, just a minute. On the Stevens Suburban Homestead, we like to make double batches, and we like to freeze the batch. A mom's going out of town to work. I run a business called Grateful Chicks, which you can also follow if you look on Periscope, Grateful Chicks. And when I'm out of town, you know, Chloe and Craig have to fend for themselves, and they have all the chores to do and the chickens to keep alive. So what I like to do is the week or two before I leave town is I like to make the double batches. But you can do the same thing so that your family, you know, you can just have more time with your family. If you make a double batch, it takes just as long to cook. And then you can freeze it like this and you can thaw it out later, like 2 weeks later, so you don't get bored. And it's easy, breezy, and fast. Does anybody want to tell me where you're from tonight and what you're having for dinner? Hannah Banana, if you're still there, what did you make for dinner? So the other thing that I add that's from the garden that I haven't picked yet is we do some fresh basil. Chloe, do you feel like running out and getting some fresh basil? That'd be great. Ham and Swiss on sourdough. Oh, that sounds like one of those yummy sandwiches from France. Basil's the one that's in the planter on the deck over there. The one that's got all the green on it. Oh, that sounds delicious. And now that they have gluten-free bread out there, you know, sandwiches are an option in our house again. Before, they really didn't have very good bread. Just ham and Swiss on sourdough. Nothing fancy schmancy. What's it called? A croque monsieur or something where they put it like in a pan and they, it's almost like a grilled cheese with the ham. Anyway. Can't think of the name. Well, I hope this was, it's a quickie video. It's nothing too fancy on this, but the thing we love to do is, grilled, is we love to try to save money and time, and we like to use our own produce. And so since I only use 1 pound of turkey, look at how Chloe chopped these bell peppers. Holy moly, Chloe. She's so cute. I will just put this in and I'll chop the rest after I get off the video. We try to put in as much vegetables as we can. For those vegetarians out there, you could just omit the meat and put in yummy veg. You could even put some carrots in there, but we had enough homegrown stuff that we didn't need the carrots. Just spaghetti, plain old like red sauce. I think it's called bolognese sauce, but I put veggies in them. And I'm sure an Italian, a true Italian, would be really upset with the fact that I'm putting in ground turkey. but just give you some ideas. And so that's pretty much it. I didn't use a recipe. I just throw in my own salt and pepper if I salt it. Garlic. I add basil from the garden. One of the other things we like to talk about here is, thank you, Hannah. Thank you. It's going to be yummy. But the other thing is that for y'all who don't have full gardens, or maybe you're not a stay-at-home mom like myself, so you find your time is a little more limited, you know, you could just grow basil in your windowsill. You know, I have a lot of things growing in my windowsill. And you could grow it in a little pot outside. And that way, if Italian food's your favorite, then you could have one thing, do one thing that's homegrown. It just feels so good. Or if you're into Mexican food, like we are here in Texas, yeah, you could just grow one thing, which would be like cilantro. So anyway, please stay encouraged is what I meant to say. And even if you don't have a full-scale garden or you don't have tons of time, you could still make meals on a budget and do like double batches and freeze, so you have saved time and you could have like one cute little thing in there that you've grown yourselves. So Hannah, where are you from? I did not take a look. I followed you, but, we get cold winters though. Oh, well, you know what? If you get cold winters, you can still do, in your windowsill, Wisconsin, you can definitely do just like a little vase. I heard on Pinterest, which may not be true. Cause I've never had to grow basil in a vase, but I heard you can grow basil in a vase. I would anticipate you would need to put like some liquid seaweed or a little bit of Epsom salt, maybe every other month, to give it some kind of nutrition, or it wouldn't last forever. Anyhow, okay, have a wonderful evening, everybody. Chloe Rose, do you want to say goodbye?
Bye.
Bye. Isn't she a doll? Yeah, check Pinterest. You can do lots of things in your windowsill. And I think I said yesterday I'm going to start doing a what's growing in my windowsill thing. Got to get the light just right so you can see it. And we'll talk about some of the things you can grow. Oh, Hannah Banana from Wisconsin said goodbye. Isn't she sweet? Look at her. Okay, we'll do another video probably tomorrow. Thanks for watching, everybody. And remember to follow us at Stevens Suburban Homestead on Facebook and Pinterest and elsewhere. Okie doke, night night.